this video I'm going to use the AirScan Shining 3D Pro. So the first thing I do is select the scanner here, I go next, then I'm going to use the quick scan on the tripod, so I hit next there. Now I'm at the new project, I'm going to call it a figurine. Press save, apply, and here you can see the figurine on the actual turntable here. As you can see, the turntable is turned here with the figurine on it, and the image is coming in here first. Turntable is set to 12 increments, so it will do 360 degrees. So there is the first scan now completed. As you can see, you can see the image of the figurine here, but there's a lot of bits and pieces that he has also scanned as well, so I want to get rid of those, so I'm just going to draw around those. Press delete to get rid of them. Just turn this around here to get rid of this piece of that. So I've deleted that. Now that's the first scan complete, so I hit the green tick here to say I'm happy with it. Just turn it up there. Now I'm going to do another scan of it on the side so that it will link the two scans together. So I'll continue the scan here, press continue. And all I've done is just turn the figurine on the side, and you can see it on the side up here. It will do a complete scan of the figurine on the side now. As you can see, it's done its second scan now, so I want to get rid of the pieces that is no good for the scan, so I just come in here and go around it and just press delete to get rid of those bits. Now that's the second scan completed, so I hit the green tick, and now it's going to merge the two scans together. There's the two scans now complete. If I turn around there, you will see that it has merged pretty good. Now there will be little areas where you can see that it's not 100% scanned, or it's hard to scan it. So what I'm going to do here is do a watertight model, so I just left click here watertight, and I go for a million detail, and now what it's doing is it's going to fill in all the holes that are in the scan. There is, I'm going to apply that, the sharpness of it. And there is the part created now. And as you can see, that is a very good scan of the actual figurine, with no holes in it whatsoever. So now, once I have it completed, sticking it up right here now, I'm going to save it, so I'll press save. I'm going to save it to the Ultimaker files, and I'm going to call it figurine. And make sure it's an STL file, and press save. Say yes to that, and I'm going to keep the scale at 100. Now I'm going to open Cura, because that's where I'm going to, that's the 3D printer I'm going to print. I'm going to open the model, go file, open. Go into my desktop, into the Ultimaker files, and go in for figurine. There's the figurine, and drag that in. Now I'm just going to rotate this model around a little bit. There is the actual model now. I'm going to lay it flat on the part. It's magenta because the color of the roll in Extruder 1 is magenta. And we have breakaway here as well. So if I go over here to edit it, it's going to be magenta in color. And if I scroll down here and put in supports on it, it's going to come from Extruder 2. It's going to be everywhere, and it will support anything that's over 45 degrees. I'm also on the start, but I'm bringing in a brim, all right, so that it holds better on the actual plate. And the build plate adhesion I'm going to put is Extruder 2. Brim is going to be breakaway white, and the supports are going to be breakaway white as well. So I've got to do now only slice that, slicing it there now, and slicing is getting the codes for the machine to actually build it. It's going to take 4 hours and 29 minutes to build, so I'm going to print that over the network. And for the remainder of the video, you will see it printed, but it'll only take about 3 or 4 minutes at different stages of the actual print. And I'll be doing that through the monitor here.